Still very much acting within the range scope boundary jurisdiction. Come alive, get on board. On this sporting platform, join me on Offside with Olaleka Efficient. On Offside, we give it to you the way you want it. We take it deep, we even go more deeper. We bring you the action, the excitement, where it's going on and how it went down. Join me on this super dial as I take you around the world of sport. For sponsorship and advert, you can call 070-35-41-51-92. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Lord God Almighty. I will say, is the Lord my God, is the name alone will I serve. Fantastic time to all the listeners. So, whatever you are listening to us from, it's another edition of your favorite sport program, Offside with Olaleka Efficient. And of course, it's Thursday, the 4th of October, 2018. And of course, it's just a day before by this time tomorrow, we'll be getting set for an amazing weekend. And of course, yes, you know, it's the number one show where we talk about major things that has happened in world of sport in the last 24 hours and beyond. And of course, we have a lot to talk about today. Magical amazing. Yes, tonight at the UEFA Champions League resumed. Yes, sir, it was 4-2 at the Wembley Stadium. Yes, sir, fantastic. And of course, people cannot stop talking about PSG and that man, Neymar Jr., still the show as he hit hat-trick when PSG smashed Sabre Gerrit 6-1. That was an amazing free kick and Neymar scored. I hope maybe that goal might find a way in the Puskás Award, for FIFA Puskás Award, sometime next season. Let's see how the things pass. And of course, it's shaping up as a UEFA Europa League will be taking place today. I'm going to give you the results of the result of the UEFA Champions League just tonight that was played, and of course the fixtures for the Europa League, and of course don't forget AFCON 2019 qualifier. You know, so many things is the information has been showing out. Libya may lose top star as they jet to CFAX for the Super Eagles. Don't forget Libya is looking forward to beat Super Eagles of Nigeria in order to redeem their hope of qualifying for AFCON 2018. And of course, that man, Alex Iwobi, has been tipped to be one of the main guys that make things happen for in Arsenal. Of course, he has to discover his form and he's doing well with some under the new manager, Unai Emery. As the problem of Manchester United still continue, yes, Fellaini is saying that the players are very, very, very they are solidly behind at the gaffer, and that is Jose Mourinho. Yes, I'm going to tell you that the transfer rumor, yes, sir, who saw this as this, you know, contradictions around whether Aaron Ramsey will sign a new deal, that the waste man is looking for a pay rise. And there's like the management and the board is reluctant to give him a new deal. I will take you into that. And of course, yes, sir, it has started falling in as Bruce has been sacked as the manager of Aston Villa. Perhaps is the first manager to get sacked. We'll go details into that. And of course, Cristiano Ronaldo has denied the rape allegation. Many things to talk about today. But before we start the show, this is our tradition. Let's go straight as well. This very short music break. The first music break, let me just take some coffee. And after that, we'll kickstart the show for you. Don't forget, it's Offside. It's with Olaleka Efficient. We'll be playing Fire featuring Ricardo Bank, featuring T.Y. Savage. Ricardo Bank featuring T.Y. Savage. Enjoy this one. We'll be back after this music break.
Fire. Shawty want $1 million. Say make a wire. Tell me to wanna cover my girl. She say all her friends leave me la vida loca. Before me, my lover. Oh, yeah, you for there for me. You for there. When the boy they hunger, yeah. I for joy. die for you. But you say if you don't get money, hide your face.
Hide my face.
Make another man picking on my race. I love you, no mean say. If you say make a put one up for fire. Fire, fire, but I go put one for fire. You no mean say. If you say make a put one leg for fire.
Yes, welcome back from that very short busy break. So sorry, I couldn't get my hands on the fire. I don't know the music is actually cue up what's a fire by Davido. Fantastic music jams, and I hope you enjoyed that one. Of course, let's go straight to the business of the day, the result of the UEFA Champions League. As it happened yesterday night, Atletico defeated Club Brugge 3-1. Yesterday night, at Spain, of course, Dortmund beat Monaco 3-0. PSV lost to Inter at home. Voila, Barcelona defeated Tottenham Hotspur. Wembley Stadium, 2-4. It was a 6-goal thriller in that one. While PSG's Sparta Prague, it was a 6-1 thriller. A 7-goal thriller, 6 goals to PSG, and of course 1 goal to Sparta Prague. That one happened in France, and of course Napoli defeated Liverpool at home. That was a little bit tough. Jurgen Klopp have been talking tough on that one, saying that his two striker up front, Sané, Firmino, and of course Wan-Bissaka, didn't play together as one. But Napoli snapped a massive 3 points, from Jurgen Klopp's side. And of course, Lokomotiv Moscow lost at home to Shakhtar 04, while Porto defeated visiting Galatasaray. Today's Europa League fixtures, we're going to see Bayern Leverkusen will host AK Nanaka Wasiewicz. Wasiewicz will host Ludogorets. Leeds will travel to Rosenborg. Salzburg will host Celtic. Bordeaux will host Colbaham. While Zenit will host Sparta Prague. Anderlecht will host Dynamo Zagreb. Fenerbahce will hold Trinidad. When Arsenal will travel to Karabakh. Of course, Sporting CP will travel to Voskala. Milan will hold Olympiacos. Of course, it's another one too. Another cracker that we must be looking for, that one. Of course, Real Betis will hold Dudenland. Rangers will hold Rapid Vienna. Villarreal will travel to Russia to play Spartak. And of course, Marcel will travel to Apollon. Frankfurt will host Lazio. And then, of course, Chelsea will also hold VDFC and Stamford Bridge Stadium. And of course, I think the match we need to look for is our Chelsea, Arsenal, and of course, that of, I think the match between Anderlecht and Dynamo Zagreb should be another cracker to watch. Of course, I told you that it was a magical performance for Messi yesterday night, as he displayed a fantastic, as Tottenham lost at home to Barcelona. Ivan Rakitic scored a wonderful volley, and Lionel Messi struck twice to inspire Barcelona to 3-4 to win at Tottenham in the Champions League. Philippe Coutinho took only 92 seconds to beat Barca to lead at Wembley on Wednesday, with Rakitic unstoppable 25 yards and doubling the Catalan side half first half advantage. And the King 10th Champions League group gave Spurs hope, and though Messi soon put Barca 3-1 up, Eric Lamela struck to set up a grand star finish, and the Supervisors men had failed to win their last 3 games and looked nervy in the closing stage. But Messi capitalized on poor defending in the last minute to ensure he still joined Inter on maximum point after after 2 group games in Group B. Iglesias was playing for the first time since August after recovering from a tight injury, but the Tottenham captain mistakenly contributed to Barca's second minute opener. Of course, a bad one for Tottenham. Still in Champions League, yes, PSG win goal on Red Star. Neymar scored hat-trick as Paris Saint-Germain thrashed Red Star Belgrade 6-1 in their second Champions League match of the season. The league champions responded to their opening 3-2 loss to Liverpool with a commanding victory over the Serbian visitors at Park the Prince on Wednesday. Neymar brilliant treble has saw him draw level with Kaká as the top scoring Brazilian in the competition history on 30 goals was added, told by Edison Cavani, Angel Di Maria, of course Kylian Mbappe. Marco Marin got a consolation for the visitor, and it is counted for little as they suffered comprehensive defeat to Thomas Tuchel's side. Yes, of course, talking about Champions League, yes, Griezmann shine as Atletico win. Antoine Griezmann scored in either half to help Atletico Madrid to a 3-1 Champions League win over Club Brugge on Wanda Metropolitana on Wednesday. After an opening win against Monaco 2 weeks ago, Griezmann doubled, and Koke late strike has given Diego Simeone's side a perfect platform to progress from Group A. The World Cup winner put his side ahead with a typical and short striker before Arnaud Grovelin gave the Belgian international an unlikely leveler with a stunning effort. This one then proved exactly why he's a Atletico talisman in 67 minutes, producing another clinical finish to set a lost Rayo Blancos on their way to 3 more points, which was sealed by Koke. Still very much on the Champions League. Yes, sir, the last match, Champions League, Liverpool, they sank to Napoli. Liverpool had fallen to a late 1-0 defeat at the hand in the hand of Napoli, their Champions League Group C clash at the Stadio San Paolo. The visitors had looked on course for a hard fought point, despite Liverpool performance severely lacking intensity we are used to seeing from Jurgen Klopp's side. But Lorenzo Insigne snatched the victory for Napoli with the winner in the final minutes of the normal time. It was a deserved victory for the home side, and in which the blue group seemed wide open, with Napoli moving top of on 4 points, or 4 ahead of Paris Saint-Germain, and Liverpool on 3 points at peace. The club need just one change from the team which duel with Chelsea at the weekend, as Navigator replaced Jordan Anderson in the starting lineup. But the returning Guinea making his Champions League debut for the club endured a short of successful play on the field. Misplaced pass by Keita gifted Napoli the best chance of the half after 11 minutes, but Lorenzo Insigne could not take full advantage as he sent a low effort bobbling narrow pass far the post. Insigne threatened again 5 minutes when he pulled a long range effort in a wide off the target, and there was more cause for concern for Liverpool shortly afterward as Keita went down unconsciously of the ball clutching his back. Yes, sir, away from that, let's go straight to what is happening down UEFA Europa League, as team line up to take on each other today. And of course, one of the teams that will be playing in Europa League is Chelsea. Say Chelsea are not favorite. This one is coming from the coach of the side, Mauricio Sarri. Chelsea boss Mauricio Sarri believes it is too early in the competition to consider his side favorite to win the Europa League, having claimed 1-0 win in bulk in their opening group game at the Blues post of Korean side VD at Stamford Bridge tonight, looking to take a further step forward towards the knockout phase. Chelsea are widely considered the favorite to lift the trophy, the last one 2013, but Sarri is wary of becoming complacent before the team, who finished third in their Champions League group, entered the competition last 32 stage. However, the Italian admits he is eager to deliver silverware in his first season at the club, even if he does not lose sleep over the pressure to win. "We want to arrive to the end of the competition," he told the news conference, "but I want to know that Europa League is a very unusual competition. At the moment, we don't know the names of all the opponents. In the second round, we arrive 8 teams from the Champions League. It is very difficult in Italy. It is it's not easy to win a trophy. In the last 7-8 years, only Juventus won trophy. It is very difficult in England. It's difficult because England, we have 6-7 teams that can win. So it's very difficult. I am here to win. I want to win. I want to win something. I hope to be able to do it. And I don't lose sleep over it. I need to sleep for 8 hours every night. Otherwise, I'm in trouble." Chelsea drop point in the Premier League for the first time at this season after their win over Falk, as they were head to a 0-0 draw by West Ham 3 days later. Sarri, who plans to make a number of changes on his lineup for video visit, admit it is more difficult to balance commitment to the Europa League than the Champions League, although he refused to blame the draw against their London rivals on their trip to Greece. Yes, I'm still very much on Europa League. Let's move straight to that club in Italy. AC Milan said Milan more, saying that Milan must be competitive. Bonaventura demand more from Rossellori. Giacomo Bonaventura wants a good Europa League role this season, as Milan have already played a leading role in Europe. The Rossellori have won their Champions League 7 times and will return to that competition if they can win this season. Europa League, Milan have always played a leading role in Europe, Bonaventura said in a press conference ahead of the Olympiacos match. We have to do our best to make Milan back high levels. We have more experience than last season, so we have to do better. The atmosphere after the Sassuolo game was positive, but we can't get too carried away. We need to be balanced when we win and when we lose, but obviously that will help us tomorrow. Bonaventura also discussed the impact of coach General Gattuso on the team. And yes, let me go back straight to Chelsea, as it is possible that the Loftus Cheek might start tonight. Chelsea midfielder Ruben Loftus-Cheek will feature in the starting lineup for the first time this season in today's Europa League games against Hungarian champion Reading. Bashusari said the 22-year-old England player has recovered from a shin problem and in line to call up white Spain winger Pedro has recovered from a shoulder problem. I have to speak to Pedro, it's doing better like Loftus-Cheek, and I think tomorrow every player is available, said Sari. I have to change 4, 6, 7 players. I don't know at the moment how many, maybe tomorrow at the time. The seal of cheek, I think the Italian manager added he was unlucky in the last 3 weeks for the national team break. He had a problem in the last 5-6 days. He has been better, and I think he will be able to play. And of course, away from that, let's go straight to the that team, the North London. Yes, sir. Arsenal has a Emery out of maintained a winning run. Unai Emery, Arsenal are looking to keep up their winning run when they meet their longest ever journey for a competitive game to face Karabakh in Azerbaijan in the Europa League tonight. The Gunners have recovered from a losing at the opening games under their new Spanish coach at Saturday's win, 2-0 win over Watford in the Premier League, with their 7th victory on the bounce. The 8th successful win in all competitions will represent Arsenal's best run since the spring of 2015, and it will leave them in a strong position to qualify from Group E after they began their Europa campaign by beating a Vuskala of Ukraine 4-2. Emery is likely to rest the leading player for the 4,000-kilometer trip to Olympia Stadium in Baku, which will host the final next May. Goalkeeper Peter Cech is out up for up to a month with an absent injury, while playmaker Eric Mkhitaryan may not play given the long-standing political tensions between Azerbaijan and its native Armenia. Those issues meant Mkhitaryan did not travel with Borussia Dortmund with Europa League game in Azerbaijan in October 2015, with the German club citing safety concerns at the time. Of course, still very much on Arsenal. Arsenal will be without Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang or Ramsey and Eric Mkhitaryan for their Europa League cup tie with Karabakh. Armenian international Mkhitaryan have not traveled to Azerbaijan with Aubameyang ill and Ramsey staying at home for the bout of his strike. Peter Cech is also out for an hamstring injury, leaving Armenia to choose between Bernardo and Emiliano Martinez for today's game in Baku. Mkhitaryan is reportedly missing the game due to the ongoing conflict between Armenia and Azerbaijan over the dispute in Ingolo Karabakh territory. When the midfielder was at Borussia Dortmund, they did not travel the Bundesliga team against Aseri in Kabala. Yes, and of course, Rangers, Scottish champion Celtic have had a poor start of the season, although Brendan Rodgers team did not beat Osasuna 1-0 in their Europa League group stage opener. The Wolves are traditionally poor on their travel in Europe, excluding qualifying rounds. They have won just twice away from home this decade, and that means they are likely to find a life tough against Austria champion Salzburg, who reacted with a semi-final last season. Rangers meanwhile face Austrian opposition to Steven Gerrard's side, who had Villarreal away from home into 2 weeks ago. Also Rapid Vienna with the visitors to Innsbruck, having just appointed a new coach. Of course, there's no way we can add that it's finished the show without talking about what is happening in Manchester United, and of course, things that surround the red side of Manchester. Zidane family dismiss interest in United job. Family source in season Zidane has said nothing about an offer from Manchester United. There have been claims on both sides of the channels that Zidane is in talk with United about replacing under fire manager Jose Mourinho. However, Le Parisien says family members insist that the former Real Madrid coach has said nothing about the move to English giant. Development suggests that the Zidane has indeed not fielded any contact from United in recent time. The French man is also been linked with a front office role at Juventus this week. And of course, still very much United, Pogba, Barca can afford 150 million euro for Pogba in Barcelona. Have reportedly been ruled out of the race for Pogba as they have no room in their budget to sign the Manchester United midfielder. The Spanish champions, along with Paris Saint-Germain and former club Juventus, are believed to have shown interest in the France international following its latest falling out with manager Jose Mourinho. Speaking on Tuesday evening, Barca boss Ernesto Valverde refused the rumor the rules out of the possibility of his side making the move at 25 years old when the transfer window reopens in January. According to the Telegraph, though, the Catalan giant cannot afford Pogba in the next 12 months, as they already have projected wage bills of 5 to 4 million euros for this season. On top of the hefty wages, Pogba will likely cost close to 150 million euros to sign, meaning that Barcelona cannot justify bringing him to the club, ending his Manchester United nightmare. However, the same report indicates that money could potentially be freed up with the sales of star names already in Valverde's squad, depending on how King President Josep Maria Bartomeu to signing the World Cup winner. Yes, of course, sir. Transfer news, yes, sir. Everton had to move from Welbeck. Arsenal forward Danny Welbeck has reportedly emerged as a potential transfer target for Everton. Welbeck has spent the last 4 years at the Gunners with 31 goals being scored from 73 starts and 46 substitute outing in all competition. However, the 27-year-old contract expired at the end of the season, and it has been suggested that the England international is not close to agreeing fresh time with the North London outfit. According to the Mirror, Everton are monitoring the situation and they decide to make an approach for the striker either in January or in the summer. Welbeck will look to find a club where he can secure regular playing in the starting lineup, and Everton could potentially offer that, which said Chip Chosen having only netted 6 times in 21 top flight outings since moving to Goodison Park in January. The attacker is currently Arsenal joint top scorer in all competition this season with 4 strikes as he's yet to make a start in the league. Yes, sir. Of course, let's see how far that one comes. Of course, still very much on the on transfer. Gattuso won't rule out move of Stratton Baramovic. AC Milan coach Gennaro Gattuso doesn't rule out a move for Stratton Baramovic, and asked Paolo Maldini and Leonardo. He said the elegant sizer has been linked with a return to Rosemary with a Major League Soccer season ending December 8th. He could join on loan in January. Today is his birthday, so I wish him many happy returns, Gattuso said in press conference on Wednesday ahead of the European Cup game. I will speak about the player I have available, as Maldini, Leonardo, and of course, Sacconi today. I just want to wish Ibra an happy birthday. Wish him all the best before. He said that in his press conference. You know, there may be something is cooking when a coach is pointing at a comment of another player indirectly. It shows that there might be something cooking that we don't know about or that is yet to be resolved. Of course, let's wrap up on the home front. While Leicester City and NFL Super Eagles are celebrating Iheanacho, the Nigerian Super Nigerian Football Federation and Leicester City have sent a congratulation message to Super Eagles Football Federation Iheanacho, who turned 22 yesterday. Iheanacho has scored once and provided 2 assists in the 7 English Premier League game this time, and was born in Imo State, Nigeria, in October 3, 1996. We wish them Iheanacho, yes sir, had many happy results. It was a very bad one as Yimba lost to Raja Casablanca at home yesterday. It might be like it might be done and dusted, but the sad thing is just that the Yimba missed the penalty in that one, an opportunity for them to secure a point which will take them to second leg. Yimba dreams of reaching the CAF Confederation Cup final hangs on the balance after 1-0 home defeat to Raja Casablanca on Wednesday, the first leg of their semi-final tie. The Nigerian side suffered their first home loss in this year competition under driving rain and revamped Yimba Stadium in Aba. Abedilila Afidi scored the only goal of the match early in the second half while Enyimba missed a penalty. The match kicked off 2 p.m. with Enyimba hoping to profit from the heat, but the heavens opened up and the Moroccans were comfortable. Chances fell out to both sides in the first half, but they were unable to take their opportunity. 3 minutes after the break, Raja punched his speculative shot from Afidi from the outside the Yimba box, slipped through the otherwise impressive goalkeeper Teofilos Afolabi's leg for the goal of a lucky even match. Yimba were offered a route back into the match when Afolabi handed the ball in the Raja box, but Stanley Yimba asked his penalty kicks. In the 63rd minute, Raja Wolves City rivals Wydad won their last season CAF Champions League title head-on for the win and are now firm favorite to finish the job in Casablanca. Yes, it's a very bad one for Yimba. Yes, of course, this is how we'll be doing it today on this edition of Offside with Aleka Efficient. And of course, I'm glad and I know that you've enjoyed every bit of news on your front off the list of pleasure. Of course, you can follow me up on Instagram at OlalekaEfficient. Of course, follow me up on Twitter at TheEfficientGuy. But the next time I come your way, I want to wish you, thank you so much for listening. Thank you and God bless you. Bye for now.